Gladys Khadebe is a resident in Cosmos City. Cosmos City is a new development area in Johannesburg. It's one of the worst affected areas in Gauteng province, South Africa's economic hub. Khadebe's livelihood has had to change drastically as a direct result of water scarcity here. A mother of four, she's now forced to change her daily routine to ensure that she accesses water.
We are really suffering. Whether you want to drink water, cook, or do anything, this is what we have to do. Come here. In my house, the taps have run dry. The only time I can get water from the taps is like at midnight or around 4 a.m. because a lot of people are sleeping, so there's not a lot of people getting water, so you can fill up the buckets. Look at this. This is what we have to deal with. I have to wait for a long time because, as you can see, water is taking forever to come out.
In other areas in Johannesburg, the water supply in some suburbs has been cut as reservoirs continue to run dry. Scientists warn that if water is not preserved, in a few years' time, the tide will in fact turn for the worse.
I'm often astounded by how blasé South African society is in terms of our water situation. We're a dry country, number one, but in the midst of a drought, people still use water as though it's a luxury.
Our message as the MINMEC is to encourage South Africans to continue using water sparingly and responsibly and to adhere to the restrictions where they may be in place. As government, we will continue with the interventions we have been implementing to support communities in need and to respond to leaks and water wastage timeously to minimize more water losses.
Experts say unpredictable climate patterns are a major contributor to the water scarcity and that drier and drier conditions are bound to persist because of drought. Yolisa Njabela for CGTN in Johannesburg, South Africa.